Here lie the remains of the late Brigadier Okoya Pirino Otto, who is alleged to have been murdered in 1970 on the 25th of January.
The abandoned graves lie side by side in a sorry state at the ancestral home of the late Brigadier in Palaro, Golo District. On a cloudy Thursday afternoon, a loam gifter is uprooting weed from the older grave, and as she looks up to the bushy pit that was dug by the UPDF Engineering Brigade, she is wondering whether government will ever fulfill its promise of turning it into a befitting and modern grave for her uncle, Brigadier Okoya Pirino.
For whatever the government have done to us, they started the program for burials of my father. Nowadays, we don't know where they are.
The son of the late Brigadier explains that the government of President Yoweri Museveni promised to rebury their father.
Promise. Several times. That we are going to do ABC, That's why we accept those people to come and do the revival. Huh? After now, I'm not sure that the government is going to participate on our plan or our activity.
54-year-old Oriam Clay, who lost his father at a tender age of 2, has become suspicious that the government is organizing a cultural ritual as a means of cleansing the people suspected to have murdered Brigadier Okoya.
We are now trying to realize the interest of those people, not for the purpose of doing the service to what they need. Their interest is to get friends with those who killed my father.
The family have set 21st of May 2022 as the final date for the funeral prayers.
When the government hear that we want to do the funeral for Mr. General Brigadier Okoya, they stopped that one. They told us to wait.
So we the children now, we are requesting the government, those who came and then dug that grave, we are requesting them to come and then do their work, finish their work, because they want to do the reburial. So if they can come and then do the reburial, they are welcome.
Brigadier Okoya Pirino Otto was murdered in cold blood in 1970 at his home in Koro, Gulu District. The Uganda Army soldiers are suspected to have shot him and his wife on orders of Idi Amin.
On the 28th of April 2022, here in Palaro Village, the family under this mango tree is meeting the Honorable Member of Parliament of this area. Among other things being discussed is why the UPDF Engineering Brigade has taken so long without completing the construction of the grave.
However, after concluding a meeting with the family members, the area member of parliament, Simon Wokorach, expressed the government commitment to rebury Brigadier Okoya Pirino Otto on the 18th of June 2022.
We have already scheduled a date in consultation with the UPDF officers that we are going to have to give the general a befitting reburial.
And the UPDF has visited the site with promises to resume the construction of the grave immediately.
It was a program that was started over 3 years back, but because of the COVID pandemic, we could not carry on. That the CDF has again rejuvenated this program. The engineers reassess the work that shall be done, so that come the D-Day, the reburial of General Okoya and his late beloved wife is done properly.
The late Brigadier Okoya Pirino Otto served as the Army Chief of Staff, deputy to former President Idi Amin Dada as the Chief of Defense Forces, and the commander of the 2nd Infantry Brigade of the Uganda Army, which was based in Masaka during Dr. Milton Obote's presidency.
52 years after his death, and exactly 3 years after the UPDF Engineering Brigade started the construction of a modern grave for the late Brigadier Okoya Pirino Otto, the 18th of June 2022 has been set aside as a date for his reburial. Joseph Omagor, the news in Palaro Village, Gulu District.